Patrick Kane, when he touches the puck, all eyes are on him. And you can kind of feel there's a palpable buzz in the building when he gets the puck, because you know something's going to happen.
And here comes Kane. He scores! Kane was shot back by Boland. Kane scores!
This historic pick, the first time ever the Chicago Blackhawks have had the first pick, and we proudly select Patrick Kane.
I remember, you know, going to the bathroom maybe 5 or 10 times in the last hour because I was so nervous before the draft. But Chicago eventually got up and I made their first overall pick in the history of the franchise and ended up being my name. So pretty exciting moment and something I'll never forget.
You know, he played his first 9 games as an 18-year-old right after his draft, and I think he scored almost 2 points a game. He lit it up pretty good, so I think there's no doubt that he was sticking around.
18, 19 years old playing in the NHL, I mean, that's pretty much every kid's dream, so I had a lot of fun. The team was on the rise. We didn't make the playoffs that year, but it was a good year overall to kind of get your feet wet and play in the NHL.
With 21 goals and 51 assists, the Buffalo native was awarded the Calder Trophy as the top rookie in 2008. And the ascension of one of the league's most electrifying talents and a powerhouse team in the Windy City continued together as a nearly 5-decade Stanley Cup drought was ended 2 seasons later.
The shot that he took in the Stanley Cup final in 2010 against the Philadelphia Flyers surprised me. I thought he was going to pass the puck. He shot that from the bottom of the left wing circle and it went into the net. Everybody in the building was stunned. Everybody thought that the play was still going on and it was actually in the net. But to me, that's the magic of Patrick Kane. He just seems to make the play that he feels is the right play at the right time.
You know, pretty amazing moment to score that overtime winning goal. I think as a kid, that's something you dream of, to be able to do that at the highest level, you know, in the NHL playoffs. Help win a Stanley Cup for the Blackhawks, first in the 49 years. It was a pretty fun moment. It's still a moment to this day that I don't know has really sunk in, but pretty cool to say he did that.
Kane, firmly cemented as a cornerstone of the franchise, helped the Blackhawks secure another Stanley Cup in 2013 while earning the Conn Smythe Trophy. And he won the Stanley Cup a third time 2 years later. In the 2015-16 season, Kane became the first American-born player ever to win the Art Ross Trophy, Hart Trophy, and Ted Lindsay Award.
He's a proven winner, 3 Stanley Cups. He's the most exciting player in the NHL right now.
He can wow you with the puck, and you know, he's fun to watch, and he's dangerous every time he steps on the ice, every time he touches a puck.
Great players in the game, even at this level, get mesmerized by a player like Patrick Kane.
But Patrick has that ability to lift you out of your seat with his offensive talent. He's got those magical hands and he's got that vision, so he certainly makes it look easy, but I can tell you, it's hard to do what he does.
He's never looking down at the puck. He's so effortless in how he handles it that he's able to really buy himself time and space by keeping everyone else guessing what he's going to do.
He's gotten better every single year. He's gotten faster, he's gotten stronger, he's done little things to improve his game. Just adds a little bit more in each and every year, and I think that strength and his quickness adds that ability. When he does have the puck, he can make things happen, and he's even more dangerous as he progresses.
I still have a bunch of fun playing this game. I still enjoy being on the ice, so you know, that's always motivation in itself.